A lot of people immediately assumed that Pinkie Pie was adopted when they saw how different she looks compared to her family. Well, I think it's completely plausible for her to not be adopted. If you've taken high school biology, then I'm sure you've already been taught basic Mendelian inheritance and the Punnett square diagram. For those of you who don't know or have simply forgotten, here's a little refresher. Basically, what happens is that certain genetic traits like eye color, blood type, or whether or not you're left-handed are determined by alleles. For each trait, almost everybody has two alleles, and what kind of pair you get determines the trait. For example, if you have two right-handed alleles, then you're right-handed. If you have two left-handed alleles, then you're left-handed. If you have one right-handed allele and one left-handed allele, then you're right-handed because right-handed alleles are dominant and left-handed alleles are recessive. Remember those two terms, dominant and recessive, because they're going to come up a lot. Each allele is either dominant or recessive. If you have two of the same dominant alleles, then the pairing is called homozygous dominant. Two of the same recessive alleles means homozygous recessive. One dominant and one recessive allele means heterozygous. When two parents have a child, each parent passes down one of their two alleles. Each allele has a 50-50 chance of being inherited. This also means that there are four possible combinations that could result from this pairing. This is where the Punnett square diagram comes into play. Suppose the father is heterozygous or has one right-handed allele or one left-handed allele. This means that the father is right-handed. Now suppose the mother is left-handed, so both of her alleles would have to be left-handed and recessive. This means of the four possible combinations, two of them result in a heterozygous right-handed child and the other two result in a left-handed child. Now, suppose instead that the mother is the same as the father, heterozygous right-handed. This means that the child has a 1 in 4 chance of being homozygous right-handed, 1 in 2 chance of being heterozygous right-handed, and a 1 in 4 chance of being left-handed. So, going by this alone, Pinkie Pie would have had to have inherited a whole bunch of recessive genes from two parents with a whole bunch of heterozygous pairings. This seems very unlikely. Genetics, however, are a lot more complicated than that. Most if not all traits are determined by multiple genes. For example, more than 300 genes or allele pairings are responsible for skin color. Even eye color and hair color are determined by more than one gene. One gene determines whether a person has brown or blonde hair. Another separate gene determines if this same person has red hair. A person with all four recessive alleles ends up with a really rare strawberry blonde hair color. There's also the issue of codominance, where if two alleles are dominant but different from each other, they both get expressed. Case in point, blood type AB. There are also some alleles that are dominant to some but recessive to others. To make things even more complicated, some alleles have this tendency to stick to their neighboring allele from a different pairing. During something called chromosomal crossover, each strand of alleles split into pieces, some of which will swap places with their respective counterparts. In fact, the X and Y chromosomes? They're just a whole bundle of alleles each taking up one half of a gene that just refuse to separate from each other. This is why when the father passes down his genes, he just passes down the whole chromosome instead of splitting it into pieces. With the mother, chromosomal crossover can totally happen. For those of you who don't know, by the way, females have two X chromosomes while males have an X and a Y. Here's the Punnett square diagram for that. Okay, with all of that out of the way, considering just how many skin colors there are in Equestria's population, I think it's safe to say that the magical talking ponies also have skin color determined by multiple genes, just like humans. In that case, maybe pony skin color is determined by the RGB color model, or red, green, and blue. According to this model, red, green, and blue are added together in various ways to reproduce a broad array of colors. Orange, for example, has 100% red, around 40% green, and 0% blue. Let's say 10 genes determine the amount of red present, 10 allele pairings determine green, and the last 10 pairs determine blue. Recessive pairings result in a lack of color, So if all the alleles for your blue genes are recessive, then you have 0% blue in your skin color. If every single one of your RGB genes are recessive, then you end up with a pure black coat color. Let's take Rarity's parents as an example. The father has 238 out of 255 red, or 90% red. He has 90% green and 90% blue. The mother has 100% red, 70% green, and 90% blue. Both of their children have high amounts of all three colors, around 90 to 100% of each. Considering the two parents also have high amounts of all three colors, this wouldn't be unusual, though the mother probably has at least one heterozygous red gene pairing. Next, we'll use Twilight Sparkle's family as an example. Twilight Velvet has 90% of each color, while Nightlight has low amounts of red and moderate amounts of green. If you compare Twilight Sparkle's coat color with her father's, you'll see that their green and blue amounts are nearly identical. The red in Twilight's coat color, no doubt, came mostly from her mother. Now, let's take a look at Pinkie Pie's family. According to the RGB model, Pinkie Pie's skin color is actually not that far off from her siblings. All four siblings have an abundant amount of blue in their coats, despite having received recessive genes from their father, no doubt because of their mother's influence. In fact, the only really big difference between Pinkie and her siblings is an excessive amount of red. This is very plausible considering both of her parents have plenty of those in their coat colors. As for Limestone Pie, she probably received enough recessive genes to bring her red and green colors to slightly below that of her siblings, but not so low as to be completely unbelievable. Pony eye color and mane colors probably don't follow the RGB model and has their own set of rules. Heck, maybe their eye colors follow the same rules as ours. The point is, genetics is a lot more complex than simply pairing up two alleles. In fact, the stuff covered so far in this video barely scratches the surface. I didn't even go into stuff like mutations or how some physical traits can naturally change over time. Most of my research was done on Wikipedia. I might even have gotten a few things wrong. Do X and Y chromosomes really do cross over? Anyways, I highly recommend you look into how genetics work on your own time. You may find some of it really interesting. Actually, come to think of it, this might be a good chance to dive right into Earth Pony, Unicorn, and Pegasi genetics. Maybe each of those traits have been bundled up into chromosomes that can't cross over either. Whatever. That's something for another day. So, what do you think? Could pony coat colors be determined by multiple pairs of alleles and not just one pair? Do these coat colors follow the RGB model? Did I horribly botch up the explanation for how genes work? Leave your comments below and let me know. Thanks for watching and don't forget to hit that subscribe button while you're at it. Oh, and just so you know, I have a Patreon. The link is right there. You don't have to check it out if you don't want to. I'm just saying, it's right there, so. Suppose the father is heterozygous or has one right-handed allele or one left-handed allele.